Neutral side action, and we're just about set to kick off. And now we bring you the coin toss, and it's presented by Nissan. Innovation that excites. The pregame festivities are over, and we're just about set to get this game underway. He's to the 20. Across the 30. And he's taken down at the 35-yard line. Well, the crowd has been waiting for him all day. Fields' big playability about to be on display in front of the home crowd here. He's set to take his first snap as he brings the offense out, Kirk.
And, Brad, this kid's reputation precedes him. The entire offense is designed around him. As his performance goes, so will his team. So let's see what he can do in front of this big crowd. Just a complete leader. Getting the ball to your tight end and allowing him to make plays in the passing game can really open things up on the outside for your real speedsters.
Receiver screen and complete.
That pass didn't look exactly right when it left his hand. Sometimes you don't get a great grip on the ball and it comes out a little wobbly.
From their own 46-yard line. Second down. Halfback's got it on the quick throw. Tackle made around the 45-yard line. They get a one-yard loss on that one.
They really just didn't have any room to work on that play. The defense just suffocated them there.
I'm not sure what happened, but one of the players is hurt. Quick throw, and he's got the tight end again. He's brought down in the open field. Farrell picks him up 6 yards with a catch. Pierce back deep to return. This punt bounces into the end zone, and this will be a touchback. The quarterback brings his troops out onto the field for the first drive of the game. Goes right around the 30. And he's taken down at the 43. So he keeps it and he gets a big first down.
The quarterback made a very good decision here not to pitch. He saw a break in the defense and just hit it for a big game.
Just gets rid of it. Second down, 10 to go. Ball on the 43. Under heavy pressure, just throws this one away. The Buckeyes had one of their key players go down earlier, but it looks like he might be able to get back in the lineup. Going the other way.
Oh, boy. I bet he knew as soon as he released that football that he shouldn't have made the throw. And that's the thing. When you're under that kind of pressure, it takes away that one split second you need to scan the area so you know where it's a safe throw.
It's first and 10. Ball on their own 20. Got it, but he's going to lose yards here. Loss of a yard.
Pretty good stand there. They weren't fooled at all by the offensive play call.
He's knocked out of bounds at about the 27-yard line. gets it out quickly. Brought down at about the 45. A nice completion to the tight end.
A good play here, and the thing that I notice is that he provides a nice big target out there for the quarterback.
The defense jumped the gun a little bit on that play.
It's easy to teach guys to watch the ball and not listen to the quarterback's cadence, but some quarterbacks are just so good at barking out the signals that they're still able to draw some of these guys offsides.
He's at the 30, and he is drilled at the 28-yard line.
You talk about a dual-threat guy. This guy can hurt you in the air or on the ground.
Throws complete, and he stopped immediately. He ran a good-looking route and picked up positive yardage.
That he did, and he made a good catch. That short passing game is where you see all those hours in the summer that you put in pay off.
Tackle right away. Fires quickly, and he's got his man.
This guy has that innate ability to get just enough distance from a defender to make a completion possible. You don't see it from every receiver, but this guy's got it.
It's the ninth play of the drive. Takes it up the middle for a nice run.
Talk about a masterpiece. This offense right now is working exactly the way they had planned all week long. I mean, so much time as an offensive coordinator and offensive staff of what you think might be.
Touchdown, Bucks! And he hits the PAT. A 10-play, 80-yard drive, and the result, 7 points.
Brad, I thought that was a textbook drive. I thought they did a really good job of showing balance, mixing the play calling with the run and the pass, just an overall well-executed touchdown drive.
Ohio State lines up for the kickoff. Anderson fields at the goal line. Brought down at the 26-yard line. The quarterback threw an interception on their last drive. Let's see if they can be more successful here.
He can't dwell on the interception.
Now he's scrambling. He takes off. Decides to slide. Five guys will be out in the pattern as they're in the shotgun. He's on the run. Slides down to the ground. Pulls it in, and that's a first down. And they push him out at about the 47-yard line.
That was a really nice play on the ball by the receiver for a substantial gain and a first down.
Go across the middle, caught, and he's tackled at the 40. He ran a good route there and was able to pick up yards underneath the coverage.
It's okay to move the ball in small portions because it relaxes the offense and can open things up for the big play.
That's a great tackle at the 39-yard line. He's level at the 40-yard line. Fourth down. They'll call on the field goal unit. backs up, and it's no good. It lands short.
The quarterback did a really good job in the last drive of finding his receivers in space, and I bet he'll be looking to do the same thing again.
Ohio State up 7 points. Makes it out to about the 50. Nice run up the middle. Hit immediately. Got some open field. Tackle around the 30-yard line. Makes it out to about the 20. He's taken down around the 18-yard line. From the 18-yard line, it's first down. Man, and they take him down immediately. The lineman got a little ahead of the snap count. Here's the call. That penalty drives them back, and they're shooting themselves in the foot here.
Well, if they could just keep their concentration, they'll avoid situations like that.
From the 16-yard line. Second down. Quick pass. He's tackled around the 10-yard line.
Did you see how he looked that ball into his hands? That's how you catch a football.
Ohio State is up 7. They'll wrestle him down in the backfield.
There are a lot of players in the college game that can make something happen when the blocking breaks down. But when it's that bad, I don't care who you are, you're going down for a loss.
So the field goal unit is on the field. They'll try for 3 points. Ohio State is hoping to make this a two-score game. He gets it up, and it splits the uprights. Looks like they're ready for the kick. He really got a hold of that kick. He's to the 20. And he's tackled at the 27. Ohio State's got a great defensive game plan, and it's working right now.
Well, even from up here, Brad, you can see their defensive speed, and they're just playing with kind of an aggressive attitude. They're going to have to maintain that to slow down this offense.
They need to show a little giddy up now, because if they don't start eating into this deficit, they could easily fall out of the game. And they get nice yardage on that run. There are 3 quarters remaining. Ohio State's got a 10-point lead. Welcome back here. We resume action now here in the second quarter. They make the stop at the 45. They'll bring him down at the 41.
They're giving away 3 yards and only making life easier for the guys on the other side of the ball.
From the 44-yard line, first down.
Ready!
Tackled after a decent pickup. Gain of 6 on the draw play. He makes it to the 38-yard line. He's scrambling. Tackle made around the 26-yard line. From the 26-yard line, first down. Well, as they take a look at that injury on the sideline, let's see what this backup can do at quarterback. He gets out to about the 25-yard line. There's a strike complete. He's down. Slings it. And they got him for a loss. A 1 yard loss.
Really, they just had nowhere to go after the catch.
They'll line it up for the field goal. The Blue Raiders quarterback down there on the sideline, and Kirk, you and I talked to him earlier this week, and he is really the main cog in this offense. Doesn't look like he's in that much pain right now. They need him back on the field before this one's over. And he's got it. Holt gets set to kick this one away. He's to the 20. And he's taken down at the 29-yard line. With one quarter down, I really haven't seen too much separation between these two squads. Might be neck and neck the whole way. Ohio State is up by a touchdown. Delayed handoff, and he's not going to get back to the line.
Think about the speed and instincts it takes for a linebacker to get from his position into the backfield to make a play like that. That's well done.
From their own 27-yard line, second down. Big hit there to stop it. Looks for his tight end over the middle. Certainly they don't have the return on here. Booming kick. Anderson takes it at the 21. They'll bring him down at the 29. Momentum swings have been fairly even. And with so little separation, this game can be drastically changed on just one or two plays. Up the middle for a nice game. To catch it. He's got nowhere to go. And down he goes at the 47.
Check.
He's taken down around the 45-yard line. Some open field. He gets out to about the 37-yard line. Quick strike to the receiver. Brought down at the 33-yard line. From the 33-yard line, it's second down. So an empty backfield with five wide receivers. They try to get a head start there.
Little stumbles like these can kill your offensive progress.
He's out of bounds around the 36-yard line.
That's some pretty timid play calling right there. Let's see if they decide to open it up a bit more.
Throws it in a hurry, and he hits him hard at the 26. Screen pass. He's got his halfback. And they'll bring him down behind the line. This is the 10th play of this drive. Here's a throw, and I don't think he got anything on that. He guns it.
They came up short here trying to pick up the first down, but they still are in field goal range, and they're going to try to come up with 3 points.
It's fourth down. It looks like they're going to try for the long field goal. It has the distance, and it's good. They line up to kick this one away. He's out to the 30. Tackle made at the 40. There's a flag down, and it looks like this one's coming back. So they'll move back after that costly penalty, and they'll have to try to get that yardage back here.
In a game that's this close, you can't afford to waste possessions.
Ohio State is up by four. Fires to his receiver, first down. Tackled right around the 42-yard line. He fires, and they couldn't hook up on that one.
That would have been a great play if the throw were just a little bit more on target.
Second down, 10 to go. Ball on the 42. Pulls down the catch, and he's got room here. Knocked out of bounds at the 34. Ah!
grabs the extra point. It was a 5-play, 79-yard drive, and they put up 7 points.
Brad, I love these kind of drives. They're old school, grind it out and earn the yards and just rip the heart right out of that defense.
So the score now, 17-6. Gets to about the 24-yard line. So we're just about ready to return to action. Immediately tackled. And that's the way you're supposed to play pitch and catch.
Absolutely. You know, this wide receiver is a difference maker. He's one of those players that has a chance to go the distance every time you get him the ball.
And he tackles him hard at the 22-yard line. A lot of concern from his teammates with a guy down on the field. First down, 10 to go. Ball on the 22-yard line. That's a great tackle at the 32-yard line.
I think that one's on the offensive line. They've got to do a better job of holding their blocks, or else this quarterback's going to be pulling turf out of his face mask all game.
Tries to buy some time. Tackle around the 29-yard line. And he didn't get much on that scramble before they drilled him.
Brad, that's a great way for the quarterback to get himself injured. He needs to be a lot more careful out there.
He zips it. He's got it. Touchdown. Receiver flew down the field on that touchdown connection.
Well, he has the speed to stretch the defense, and his hands are getting better every single game.
And he hits the PAT. A 5-play, 76-yard drive, and that's good for a touchdown.
I think the big thing there, Brad, is that they were able to execute the passing game. When you can get big plays and great execution, obviously you're going to move the ball down the field.
The score now, 17-13. Caught at the 8. Brought down at the 32. Ohio State's offense is just clicking on all cylinders, Herbie, right now. It's everything they planned for, and it's all working.
Everything is coming together for this offense. They seem to be getting better with each series. And, you know, this game started where this team was, you know, they wondered if they were going to be able to move the ball against this defense. And I think right now, I think they seem to, as I said earlier, they seem to be growing with their confidence with each possession.
And they got it. The Buckeyes taking their first time out of the half. From their own 31-yard line. Second down, Ohio State is up 4. There's a strike complete. He's taken down around the 39-yard line. He's tackled at the 47-yard line. The Buckeyes call a timeout. That's their second of the half. They make the stop at the 45-yard line. And he is drilled at the 40-yard line. From the 25-yard line. It's first down. Kicks away, and he just drilled it from long range. Folks, that's the end of the first half, and this game's getting interesting. Ohio State's lead is a touchdown.
Glad to have you with us in the studio for the EA Sports NCAA Football 14 Halftime Show presented by Nissan. Innovation that excites. Reese Davis and David Pollock here, completely locked in on that first half. This game's been everything we anticipated it being, each team matching each other blow for blow. Just a one-possession game at this point. What do you expect to change things in the second half?
Well, it's always fun to watch two teams and two games match up the hype. And we talk about it all week and how big this game is, and it's going to come down to players making plays. And, you know, the big play is something that we continue to beat into the ground, and which one doesn't give that up? A lot of times, you know, games are lost and won by turnovers and giving it away and making that crucial mistake. You can do everything right and you can execute right, but it just takes that one misstep, that one turnover to really put you in a bad position or a bad situation that can determine this game. That's what it looks like it's going to. Both teams executing well. Who's going to make a big mistake?
Just about ready to start the second half. We're going to watch all the games around the country, including some coaches who like to sample the surface that they're playing on. I'll keep an eye on that.
Yeah, I'm going to go to the cafeteria. You want some turf, some AstroTurf or anything?
Yeah, if they've got some, I'll chew on that in the second half. Here's the second half for you to chew on with Brad and Kirk.
All right, Reese, David, thanks, guys. Just about set to start the third quarter. He's to the 20. At the 30. And the kicker comes in to make the tackle. Man, both offenses here in this third quarter have been on fire. Time for the defense to step to the forefront a little bit.
Makes you wonder which of these defenses has the ability to come up and make a stop. It could be one of those games where whichever defense comes up with that stop could be the team that wins the game.
This deficit can be easily overcome, sure. But they have to be thinking if they don't get something going on this series, the burden is going to be felt by their defense. They'll bring him down around the 43-yard line. After a decent run up the gut. Nice run there. Made right around the 36-yard line. Out of bounds, right around the 34. Run up the middle. So it's third down now, and they're going to need about four. And they'll get him in the backfield.
He wasn't decisive at all in that option. And once he kept it himself, there was no place to go.
He gets it up, and it's wide left. No good.
Every time you have a chance to finish a drive with points, you've got to capitalize. That time, they couldn't come through.
It's a new possession for this offense, so what will it hold? Ohio State is up seven. He steps out at the 37. It up the middle for a nice run. handoff, and he won't make it. The punting team's got to give their kicker some time. He's pushed out of bounds.
Right around the 32-yard line. There's still plenty of time to keep running their offense as usual here. I don't think they need to feel any anxiety about trailing. Throws completely stopped immediately.
That's how we do, D. That's how we do. They don't want to know. They don't want none of this.
Nice run up the middle. Tackled after a decent pickup. The ball is loose. Scooped up by the offense. So the question here is whether or not his knee hit the ground before the ball came out. And the booth is going to take a few looks at this to see whether or not the ball came out before he was down. So the booth and the referee agree. The runner's knee was down.
That was still a close call, though, Brad. Even though he was down, this guy has to do a better job of holding that football.
And he carries the ball for a nice gain. He goes out of bounds at the 37-yard line. There's a strike complete. He's down. Some movement on the line. They'll give this one another try after the flag.
And on third down, too. That's when you don't want those kind of things to happen.
Third down now, and they need to get it down to the 31. Off balance, and they can't connect. The kick is up, and it's no good. It lands short. So the senior kicker is unsuccessful this time. So the score is still 20-13, Ohio State. The defense really shut these guys down the last time they had the ball.
Three down.
Ohio State up 7 points. And down he goes at the 48. He scrambled. Now he's going to run and watch out. Slides down to the ground. And he's tackled after positive yardage. Solid 5-yard pickup there on the halfback option. He's going to try and scramble.
and he's taken down at the 23.
This one might be coming back, folks. Let's check out the penalty.
Little stumbles like these can kill your offensive progress.
It's second and 13. Ball on the 38. Here's the throw, and I don't think he got anything on that. Fires complete over the middle. Brought down around the 28-yard line. So the kicker comes out. He'll try to put 3 points on the board. Ohio State can make this a two-possession game with this field goal. It's up, and he nails the long field goal. The kicker looks like he's ready to kick this one off. He'll take it from the two. He's tackled at the 23-yard line. There's got to be some sense of urgency to this offense right now. They don't have the luxury of wasting drives if they want to get back in the game. They'll drop him for a loss. We've got a second and 11. Ball on the 22. He's out to the 30, and he's tackled at about the 31. He might have a chance. He gets to about the 41-yard line. At the 47. Nice run to the outside. And they'll run him again. He gets out to about the 48-yard line. And they get nice yardage on that run. They're about 4 yards away here on third down.
Good, solid defense there to force him into a fourth down situation.
Well, this turned out to be a pretty good ball game, and we've got 1 quarter to go. The Buckeyes with a 10-point lead. Back in this very pivotal fourth quarter. Scrambling around. He gets sacked on the play.
It's always a gamble going for it with so many yards to come up with. But when you're behind, sometimes you have to take risks to get back into a ball game.
A conversion there could have really helped him, but it just wasn't to be. Both teams are well aware that a score on this drive is going to create an almost insurmountable lead. This defense has really got to step it up and make a stop. Fires out quickly to the tailback. He gets hit out of bounds at the 46. He makes his way out to about the 35. Get the call again. He makes it to the 35-yard line. They bring the quarterback down.
The offensive line has to at least slow the guy down a little bit. He was in there in no time.
Third down now, and they need to get it to the 25.
Mike 42.
He heaves it deep. Keeps his eye on it, makes the catch. And he scores! Touchdown! He makes the PAT. It was a five-play, 55-yard drive, and it results in a touchdown.
Fred, I thought the offense did a really nice job of mixing up the play calling on that drive. I thought the defense was on its heels most of the drive because of the versatility of the offense.
It's fielded at the two. And down he goes at the 28. And here we go with the offense ready to get things going again. And hit hard as he came down with it. He's tackled at the 38. He's on the run, and they got him.
It's a big-time effort sack by the defensive end. I want to also give some credit to the coverage downfield. The end never gave up on the play, but because the quarterback didn't have anywhere to go with the football, it gave the defensive end enough time to eventually chase the quarterback down for that sack.
Looking to dig themselves out of a little hole here after the sack. It's second and 14. Gets rid of this one. Empty backfield, quarterback in the gun, five wide receivers. He chucks it downfield. Great catch there before they can knock him out of bounds. They'll line up with five wide receivers. He's scrambling. He's got the corner. He's at the 20. Decides to slide. He catches another. He's taken down around the 3-yard line. Touchdown, Blue Raiders.
drives the extra point. Holt has his kick team lined up, and he is set to kick this one off. Taken at the five. He makes it out maybe to the 26-yard line. They did a great job on their last drive, moving the ball down the field for a touchdown. Let's see if they can duplicate that on this drive.
As long as this quarterback has time to throw, then you can guarantee that he'll find the open man.
They'll bring him down at the 28-yard line. Of five there.
Well, that play was sort of out of sync from the start, but you have to also recognize that the defense made a great play. They read it from the get-go.
From their own 23-yard line, third down. Zips it to the back, and they make the stop right around the 28-yard line. Anderson is back to receive. Tackle made at the 41-yard line. This young quarterback's been a big factor today, Kirk.
This is what's kept the defensive coordinator up all week long, is he might be able to draw up a scheme to stop this offense, but an athletic quarterback who can create like this is just too tough to be able to contain for four quarters. This guy is so versatile. As a defense, you just can't let your guard down because he can hurt you in so many different ways. And we've seen that today, the way he's thrown the football.
So even though he's got all the stats and a bunch of good plays, it hasn't been enough just yet. They got into the end zone last time. Let's see if they can match that on this possession.
You can bet this defense made some adjustments on the sideline, though. I don't know if they can stop the passing attack, but they need to at least be able to slow it down.
Tackle made at the 38-yard line. That's a loss of about three.
Not much going on there. Those kind of plays will not work against this defense. You can be sure of that.
From their own 38-yard line, second down. With a quick throw. In the air, it's intercepted. And down he goes, around the 46-yard line.
I'm really impressed with this guy's closing speed on the ball. He's got the kind of jets you need to be a standout corner.
From their own 46-yard line, it's first down. To the back. They bring him down in the backfield. A little more than 2 minutes to go in the fourth quarter. Nice run there. Taken down right around midfield. That play was designed to pick up a first down, but they didn't do it.
It looks like the receiver just lost track of where he was on the field.
Anderson is back deep to return.
They take over after the punt, needing to put some points up on the board.
They need to score here, then recover an onside kick and score again. Although this game isn't over yet, I just don't think they can accomplish that feat with this much time left in the game.
He passes it. Brought down in the open field. And that play could have gone for six.
Oh, boy, you're right. And all week long, this secondary did a lot of talking about how they were going to dominate these receivers. I think this is time that they step up and prove it on the field. Forget about talking trash. Let's see how they react after giving up that big play.
Brought down at about the 43-yard line. He fires left side. Second down, 10 to go. Ball on the 43-yard line. Just over a minute in the fourth quarter. He airs it out. And he's got the freshman. Huge gain, and that sets him up nicely with a first and goal. Steps out at the 2-yard line.
Did you see how he looked that ball into his hands? That's how you catch a football.
It's second and goal. Ball on the 2. Dives and he's down. He gains a couple of yards on the carry.
You're not going to be able to get by a sure tackler like this linebacker too often.
Pressure coming. Quick strike to the receiver, touchdown. Late in the fourth quarter now, and with that score, this game's a one-possession ball game, and it's really going to get tense from here on out. The draw within a field goal. He splits the uprights with the extra point. He's tackled at the 41. This might be it. They've got the lead, but if they add to it, they know they've got a victory. And this should be a kneel down as they just try to kill the clock. The offense lining up in a victory formation, and he takes a knee. Second and 12 coming up here. Ball on the 43. Under a minute left. The quarterback takes a knee, and that's always a good sign if you're a fan of this team. Huge stop right there here late in the fourth quarter in a game this tight. That might be one we look back on later and say that won the ball game. Ohio State staff just dancing on the sideline. Their star player came through for them, and they couldn't be happier.
Well, the staff has to feel good. The entire team should feel good. And I know you and I just having a chance to sit back and watch this young man play. Just an outstanding performance and something that this entire team will be able to build on.
For EA Sports and Kirk Herbstreit, this is Brad Nessler saying thanks for tuning in, and we'll see you next time.